We would like to welcome everyone and thank you once again for coming to our Patriot Day ceremony. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance to the United States of America. Please stand if you're able. All those cover, hand salute. All those in cover, hand over their heart. Please stand. Arm. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Order, arms. To honor those we lost on September 11, 2001, and those we lost while serving our country during our war on terrorism, we will lower our flag at half-mast. At this time, I would like to introduce and welcome some of our distinguished guests and invite them to say a few words. From our District Congressional 11, Congresswoman Cheryl.
Thank you. It's really an honor to be here today with so many people who've done so much for our community to come out and remember who we are as a country, even in one of the times of our greatest peril. I've been to quite a few memorials already this morning. I've been with family members who've lost someone on 9/11. In previous 9/11 memorial ceremonies, I've stood at the Pentagon to remember those who lost their lives there. And you know what comes back to me time and time again right now as I'm standing here today is the sense that on that day there were so many dichotomies, so many things that didn't resonate. When I woke up that morning, it was one of the most beautiful days of the year. And I always recall that beautiful blue sky. In fact, I've had so many people say the same thing, and there was even a museum at Freedom Tower who had that had an exhibit about the color of the sky that day, because I think it struck so many of us that was that perfect September day when it felt like so many things were possible as students were returning to school and starting college. I was a young lieutenant at the commander of the U.S. Atlantic Fleet headquarters with my career ahead of me. So much was possible, and it felt like an added horror that day to see it happen on such a beautiful day of possibility, to see our country attacked because of our beliefs. And despite the horror of that day and the aftermath, what was so beautiful was to see the communities come together. The stories of heroism. I heard from a woman this morning who was leaving the towers as first responders were going up the stairs to rescue people into the towers. I heard a story of a man who actually had gone back to his hotel room to change his shirt while the other members of his group went into the towers for their meeting and perished. So many difficult stories, but so many stories of true beauty, of people coming together and standing together as a nation. So as we come here today, as we think of the nation's longest war and those who gave their lives to protect our freedoms here at home, I think we owe it to them. We owe it to every hero from that day and going forward to now as a nation remember who we are. Remember that there is more that unites us than divides us. Remember that we all deeply and dearly love this country and our values. And remember all of those who've worked so hard over the years to bring us together. And vow today that we will never forget here in Morris County what happened on that day and those we lost. So thank you so much for doing this. And I will just say that of all towns, of all groups, I think you really demonstrated that when you brought the moving wall here. And thank you for everyone who did that. Thank you, Senator Boop. I know you worked hard on that as well. And our commissioners and our VFW here to bring us together and remember who we are. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Congresswoman. At this time, I'd like to introduce, no introduction, actually, State Senator Buckle.
Before I start, let me just thank the Post here in Randolph for all that you do, for holding these remembrance ceremonies at 9/11, Veterans Day, Memorial Day. You know, we don't do it enough. We don't remember enough, and we don't say thank you enough for those that have served to protect our freedom and those that have given their lives. So please give a round of applause to the Post for continuing to, and thank you for giving me a few minutes to say a few words today on this solemn occasion. And, you know, as I thought about what I would speak about today, I looked back and I thought about all of the things that we have learned from 9/11. We learned that as a country and as a people, we need to remain vigilant, because there are still those out there, unfortunately, that would want to do us harm, to disrupt our way of life, to attack our freedoms, to try to harm our patriotism. So we need to be vigilant. We need to remember what happened that day could happen again. And we need to remember that. We learned that on those tragic events, that heroes emerge. Heroes emerge. The first responders that rush to those sites. Common, ordinary people that risk their own lives to save others. Whether it was in the towers, on a plane, the Pentagon. We witnessed those heroes and the sacrifices they made on that day. But that's what America is all about. That's what it's always been about. We learned the names of those that we've lost. We listen to them as they're read. We remember them. Their families that continue to struggle with the loss. Those that volunteered at Ground Zero. Those that worked there, that struggle today with the aftermath and the health effects of what we now know was a bad environment. They continue to struggle. We've learned that. And in the days following 9/11, we learned how our country could come together, the patriotism that we saw. We couldn't go down a street anywhere without a flag flying from every home. People embraced the flag. They embraced our nation. They contributed to charities. They volunteered. They joined the military to serve our country. We could use a little bit of that today, as our nation is so divided. We could use a little bit of that cooperation and that understanding amongst people that we had following 9/11. And that's why today is so, so important. That's why these events are so, so important. Because we now have an entire generation that did not witness those horrific events. And we can never let them forget the importance of what today represents. And that's why in Trenton, I introduced and was a prime sponsor of bipartisan legislation to require 9/11 to be taught in our schools in an age appropriate manner, so that those that were not born will understand what we've learned, what I've just spoke about. It's critical. It's critical to our nation. And if we want our nation to be together and to be proud and to respect the flag and serve our country, those are the type of lessons that our children need to learn. And they need to learn just like they're here today. And they're listening to those of us that are here to speak. So I want to thank the Pope for giving me this opportunity. Thank you for bringing people of Randolph and the surrounding municipalities together for this opportunity. We can never forget. We can never forget what happened. We can never allow our nation to lose its respect for our flag and for its people. And today is a day to remember that, to reflect on it, to remember all those that lost their lives and those first responders that ran into the danger while others were leaving. And for those common heroes, who some will probably never know their names, that saved lives on those days. So thank you for allowing me to say a few words. God bless America. God bless each and every one of you, and God bless all of those souls that we lost on that day. Thank you.
Thank you, Senator Bucco. This time I'd like to hear from State Assemblywoman Ora Dunn.
Good morning. It is an honor to be here today, and thank you for every year composing this event so the residents can take a pause and reflect and remember. So, of course, gave me an opportunity to reflect. Today, September 11th, 2001, is 21, an entire generation. Like so many of us who knew the pre-9/11 world, we remember exactly where we were and what we were doing. I was nursing my two-week-old daughter and desperately trying to get a hold of my husband to be able to bring home my two-year-old daughter, who had just been dropped off minutes before at the child care center on Capitol Hill. At the time, we weren't sure where the third hijacked plane was headed, but it was believed to be headed for the Capitol. So as we say the words, never forget, I am grateful that I won't. But for the 21-year-old, that young adult who can now vote, gamble, rent a car in New Jersey, and run for Congress in 4 years. You, of course, don't remember. But how is it that you know all too well? While September 11th awakened our awareness to the threat of terrorism, you lived with this knowledge your entire life. Foreign and domestic, and even as close to home as the grocery aisle and the school hallway, the fear and anxiety of what next hovers. And perhaps the COVID-19 pandemic, please may it be your capstone course in resilience. So as the nation today is plagued with political polarization, I'm counting on you, 21. You were born in a moment of unity and fellowship in the wake of the attacks on our soil. Americans came together, we held hands, we wiped each other's tears, and we didn't ask who you voted for in the previous election. We didn't care. You can capture the best of us. You can be the best of us, 21. From a stronger military to a respected and supported frontline workforce, building peace anywhere they're called, the classroom, the emergency room, the conference room, and the public square. 21, you will ensure that not a single one of the 3,000 lives lost, 64 of them here from Morris County, will not be in vain. David Corlone, Jason Jacobs, and Stephen Russin, all of our Randolph residents whose occupations brought them to the trade towers that fateful day. So let's all bow our heads for a moment to honor these victims and send strength to 21. God bless you. God bless America.
At this time, I'd like to hear from County Commission Director Typhoon Salem.
First, thank you for the opportunity to say a few words. In 2001, September 11th, I was here in America in my fifth year as a young immigrant from another country, working with an H-1B visa, a firm in Morristown, trying to get our green card, then trying to become a citizen of this great nation. And when I was talking with my wife that morning, and we couldn't believe, we were shocked that this was happening to the country that we love, we want to be a member of, the citizen of. So that's my September 11th memory. And I have a speech here that I'm going to read. Hope I don't bore you. Good morning, everyone. And I'm the Morris County Commissioner Director. On behalf of Morris County Board of County Commissioners, I thank you for all of you for joining us today. An annual remembrance of the people we lost, including many of the heroes who responded to the terrorist attacks of September 11th of 2001. No act of terror will stop us in America from governing ourselves through the messy yet wonderful process known as free democracy. And there is no better nation on this planet because of that. Today, the 21st anniversary of the attacks. An entirely new generation has grown up since that terrible day. Our vow to never forget is challenged by every passing year, as many of our family, friends, and colleagues who witnessed the destruction and death grow older, move from here, and pass on. It makes me think of our dear friend Emerson Crooks, a Vietnam veteran who spoke when Vietnam Moving Wall came to the County College this summer. Emerson begged us not to forget the service that took the lives of so many of his generation. He talked of seeing many visitors to the Vietnam Memorial in Washington, D.C. recently. But there were far fewer visitors at the memorials for the Korean War and World War II. And no one at the World War I Memorial. We say never forget, but time takes a toll. What happened on 9/11 and the lessons learned will only be remembered if our future generations continue to carry the torch. Thank you very much.
At this time, I would like also to introduce to you one more person, which is Mr. Tony Iacono. He's the president of Community College of Mars. Mr. Iacono.
For the men of our post 7333 and the remarkable service they've shown our country and the example and leadership they show to armed our men and women in the armed forces today as well. Sometimes we refer to you as veterans, and that's appropriately so, but sometimes we think of the word veteran also as recognizing, celebrating, appreciating past accomplishments, and they are very much leaders and active in our communities today as well. So thank you for what you bring to our community, for organizing this and bringing it into your home today so that we don't forget, as it's been said continuously up here as well. It's hard to imagine so many years have gone by. Those of you who know me as the president for County College of Morris. Long before then, I was a professor teaching American history. And on that morning, I was teaching a class. Little did I know that we'd be experiencing one of the most powerful, defining moments in our nation's history. I think it is important, in the words that are most apropos, are never forget. But on a day like this, in a place like this, a room is filled, and there are rooms like this all over our town, our state, and our nation, so that we do remember. It was, without a doubt, the defining moment of our generation. Younger generations need to be taught as a matter of history and included in this experience as well. There's only three times in our nation's history post-revolution that we've experienced an attack on our soil, and this is one of them. It's also important, I think, to remember that for many nations, this is a daily occurrence as well. So the importance of a strong armed service of American men and women who are around the world and dedicated public servants like those sitting behind me. It was a day that we didn't care what party someone was from. We were all Americans on that, and I think that in many ways that's always worth remembering each and every day. And we thank our veterans, our firefighters, our police officers, many of whom didn't make it past that day, many of whom put their own lives on the line and sacrificed. I was in South Florida at the time, but around the nation, around the world, the gratitude was overwhelming, and I hope that our police officers who are here today, firefighters, first responders, know that and know that we will never forget you. Being in a room like this matters. Thank you, Post 7333, for bringing us there. Thank you to the officials behind me and others like you who represent, serve, and lead us every day. There were a lot of decisions that had to be made. They were the right ones. Only invaded 3 times after the revolution. We endured, we prevailed, we survived every one of those. That's what makes America great. Thank you.
Our township mayor could not be with us this morning, so our deputy mayor, Lou Nisibokia, will say a few words.
It's okay, Commander, no one can say it. Sure, you're laughing, but I have to follow the history professor. Good morning, everyone. Mayor Power apologizes. She could not be here this morning. She had a commitment as well as several other council members today. Here from the council also are council members Jim Lovies and Joe Hathaway. On behalf of the mayor and township council, I'd like to thank the members of Randolph VFW Post 7333 for hosting this ceremony today and all the ceremonies you do all throughout the year. We're very grateful for you, for everything you do. The morning of 9/11 started out to be a great day. Unlike this morning's weather, it was a beautiful day. The air was crisp. The sky was blue and clear without a cloud in the sky. A pilot's dream. So when my phone rang, alerting me to the news that a small plane had crashed into one of the towers, I was surprised. Those of us that fly small aircraft know that the initial news reports are typically incorrect, and it's a good practice to wait for the official accident report before jumping to a conclusion. However, history tells us that those initial reports were in fact not correct, and that our lives would be changed forever. Many of us were numb to the events of the day. Many of us were sad. Many of us were quite angry. What followed was a time of unity, where we truly set our differences aside and came together as a nation. American flags were proudly flown out front many of our homes, and American flag decals were affixed to most of our cars. It reminded me of my youth growing up in this town, where American flag was regularly found out front everyone's home. Our first responders, some of them here today, were recognized as the true heroes they are. And members of our armed forces were thanked for their sacrifices. It was truly a wonderful time. I want you to all take a moment and recall those immediate weeks and months following that infamous day. Being so close to New York City, we all knew someone somehow linked to the day, whether it be someone who survived, or someone who succumbed, or someone who volunteered at Ground Zero for search and rescue efforts. Our own Randolph Township Fire Chief, Tony Michella, spent 8 days toiling through the wreckage with his brothers, searching for life that was not to be found. 21 years have passed, and while time may have faded our memory of that fateful day, time has also faded our sense of patriotism. But we are all in this together, as the Constitution says, in order to form a more perfect union. We need to stop letting our personal differences tear us apart. Not just in our community, not just in our county or our state, but everywhere in this great nation. United we stand. Please join me in remembering the 4 Randolph residents who perished on September 11th. Frank Joseph Skidmore, David G. Carlone, Stephen Harris Russin, Jason Javis. Let us never forget. Thank you.
And a special salute to our first responders. Thank you. And to our veterans. Thank you. Once again, at this time, we would like to pause for a moment of silence for five of our neighbors who perished on that fateful day in the World Trade Center. From Randall Township, once again, David G. Carlisle, Stephen Harris Russin, Francis Joseph Skidmore, Jr. From Chester Township, Greg J. Frowler. From Mendon Township, Jason Kyle Jacobs. May they rest in peace. Once again, I want to say good morning to all of you that braved the weather and came out to participate in this ceremony. September 11th. 2001. It was the day when across the country, daily tasks and meetings were put on hold. Millions of Americans were frozen in horror as we witnessed a brand of ruthlessness and evil beyond the realm of comprehension. It was difficult to grasp the scope of the tragedies that day. It was the single most tragic day in the terms of fatalities in our nation's history, next to the Battle of Antietam on September 17, 1862. Many of us thought it was the worst day of our lives. For many of us, the memories of that day are as vivid and painful now as they were more than two decades ago. While time cannot ever remove that pain, we can find some consolation in remembering how our nation was united in the subsequent days and months following the attack. Our nation came together to ensure evilness didn't triumph over good that day. The accounts of hope and heroism that emerged from the rubble of Ground Zero, the Pentagon, and the rural Pennsylvania field inspired us all. To this day, those remarkable chronicles of valor serve as reminders of all that is good and true in the human spirit. In our grief, our nation and its citizenry stood tall and defiantly, proud in the face of our enemies as police, firefighters, and airplane passengers gave their lives to save those fellow men. Their heroism will never be forgotten by a grateful America, nor by the VFW, who by their own experiences recognized heroism and the high cost that comes with it. From that day, we made a determination that no such attack will again be visited on us or any other nation. We learned that we must combat terror and those who seek to deliver terror. Today, we're fighting to ensure that the liberties we enjoy, the freedoms we cherish, will be secure for future generations. Today, we honor the memory of those lost on September 11th. Know that our nation indeed more secure, the resolve born out of tragedy made us stronger and has made us better as a nation. We would transform on September 11th. And as citizens, we have spent the last 21 years determined that America continues to be the bright and shining example of liberty and democracy for all nations and people to emulate, just as it has been since its grand inception in 1776. As we pause to remember those who lost their lives on that day, let us also give thanks to the men and women serving our armed forces for all the sacrifice they do and they make for all of us. There is no duty more important than protecting America, our citizens, our ideals, and our way of life. Accordingly, they so widely epitomize the words duty, patriotism, and honor. For generations to come, Americans will look back on September 11th and remember their responsibilities to preserving liberty and maintaining our ideals, and by doing so will, just as we are doing today, honor the memory and the deeds of September 11th. As we leave here today, let us each vow to do more than we did the day before, to serve our communities and our nation by committing ourselves to our families, to our communities, and to our country. We continue to show the world that what makes America great, so unique. It is what makes America a symbol of hope. I believe that is the best way to honor the memory of those lost due to the events of September 11th. Thank you.
Uncover. Dear Lord, we pray for your peace as we remember the terrorist attacks of 9/11. May our suffering from these attacks awaken our awareness of the pain and fear that so many around the world live each day. May we pray for those who struggle against oppression and injustice. Powerful God, we turn to you for peace and security as we recall the 9/11 attack. We thank you for the bravery and the sacrifice of those who saved lives and sacrificed their own. Firefighters, police officers, rescue crews, colleagues, and people aboard United 93. Continue to comfort and strengthen the family and friends of those who died. Give healing and patience to the survivors of the attacks who still today live with continued physical and psychological pain. Assure each person whose life changed forever of your protection and strength. Dispel the nightmares, the silence and anxiety they experience. May we learn to depend of the security that only you can offer. Guide the choices of our world leaders. Give them the wisdom and discernment to prevent 9/11 attacks from ever occurring again. Have them lessen terror of all sorts, from genocide to hunger, from drought to bombings. May their actions bring your peace to all the people of the world. As we remember 9/11, may it remind us that where only true security gives us your strength to face the memory of this attack and the changes it made in our lives. Give us your compassion to help each other and recognize the needs around the world. Give us your hope as we face an uncertain future. In your name we pray. Amen.
Please stand if you're able. Thank you. This ends our Patriot Day ceremony. We thank you for coming and joining us in this solemnly remember the events of this day and honor the service and sacrifices of those who were lost as a result. Thank you for joining us once again, and please get home safe.